Hey, I want to show you something over here that's pretty cool. So I just shot a clip that FiLMiC Pro compressed to a proxy file and instantly uploaded to the cloud. Pretty crazy, huh? You probably heard that Adobe acquired FrameIO last year, and it's now part of Creative Cloud. That part was just announced recently, which is pretty great, and now you can add FiLMiC Pro into that mix. If you don't know what FrameIO is, it's a cloud-based collaboration platform for client video approvals, sharing footage, reviewing dailies, and a lot more. Now, including C2C, camera to cloud, and that's where FiLMiC Pro comes in. Which, by the way, they've had C2C for higher-end productions for a little while, but now integrating that part with FiLMiC Pro is what's brand new. Now, as you're shooting, you can automatically upload proxy files to the cloud to FrameIO within FiLMiC Pro, and anyone on your production team, including your editor, can view that footage. Not only can they view that footage, they can download that footage. That means that anywhere in the world, they can simultaneously be editing while you're shooting. So to use this new feature, you do need to have the FiLMiC Pro Cinematographer Kit, and you need to have a FrameIO account. And by the way, there are some hardware limitations to using this. It works with the iPhone 11 or later, and then on Android, it works with Android 7 or later, and then it will depend on the device you're actually using. And within FrameIO, on their website, you need to set up a new C2C folder, camera to cloud folder. Then once that's set up, you come back in FiLMiC Pro, and there's a FrameIO icon here now. You click that. Now, I've already gone through this, but you would, on this top line here, log in to your FrameIO account, and then that will actually connect it to FiLMiC Pro. After it's connected, you choose the proxy quality. I've tested all three, and for me, the best quality that meets file size is the LQ, 1080p LQ. I tried 720p, and I found that it was a little bit too blocky, especially for checking focus, which I found to be pretty cool. And so 720p is a little bit too low quality because of the compression. So I would choose 1080p, LQ, or HQ, and LQ I found to be the best. And the other thing you need to do is choose your upload method. You can do automatic, which would obviously automatically upload as soon as the shot is taken, or you can do prompt, or you can turn it off if you're not going to be using this feature on a particular project. I have prompt on because if I shoot a shot that's a bust, I don't upload it. But then of course, if you want to use it, you hit okay. So I'll record a quick demo clip here. I'm shooting ProRes 422. As soon as that's over, I get a prompt. Upload to FrameIO. Do you want to generate a proxy and add this clip to your upload queue? And I'll hit yes. And so it downsamples that clip that quickly, and it uploads it in the background right then, as long as you are connected to the internet. You obviously have to have an internet connection, either via Wi-Fi or 4G or 5G. They're all very quick, I've discovered, regardless of which way you're connected. Then you come into the library, and then it instantly signifies that that proxy has been uploaded right here on this purple strip in the bottom corner. And the original file is there too. That way you have both files, the original and the proxy, on the phone in the FiLMiC library, and then the proxy file is up in the cloud. Now that file is available in the cloud on the FrameIO website, which you can look at it there on a computer, or you can check it out in the mobile app on an iPhone or an iPad. It's also now available directly within Premiere Pro or in LumaFusion. Remember, you can connect either one of them with the FrameIO plugin. And if you use LumaFusion, you can do an offline proxy edit and then export an XML to finish that in Final Cut Pro, DaVinci Resolve, or in Premiere Pro. So again, this means that an editor could start working right away, or a client could review footage, let's say they're not on location, or a member of your team, your production team, could do the same thing. What I've been doing is using it in combination with shooting ProRes on my 13 Pro Max, because those files are huge, they're really big, and when you transfer those to a computer, it takes forever. You gotta do that at some point, but using this method, using FrameIO, you can then see the files instantly on your computer or on your iPad, and that way you know what's going on, you know what the footage looks like, and you can start editing. So again, having them instantly available to review or edit using the C2C feature has been awesome. I recently shot a new short film and had a day's worth of footage all right at my fingertips before I transferred anything to the computer. Not only was this a big help to organize the footage, it also gave me peace of mind that I got certain shots in focus. Because with this, you can quickly see them on a big screen on a computer or iPad versus just on the small iPhone screen. By the way, are you noticing anything interesting about these files I uploaded? They're actually logged. Yep, ProRes Log is now in FiLMiC Pro 2 as part of this update. They call it Log V3 Plus, and I'm gonna have a video about that very soon. But again, transferring these large ProRes files from your phone to a computer is a very slow process at the moment. I definitely hope this changes in the future with the addition of a USB-C or Thunderbolt port on the next iPhone. But either way, it's great to have this ability to see your footage almost instantly in the cloud, and depending on the project, start editing. So you may be asking, who is this for? And it's really for anyone, in my opinion, that wants to collaborate, share footage, whether that's with team members on your production or with clients, or even if you're doing solo stuff and you have a lot of footage you're dealing with, like large ProRes files, as I mentioned. But I would think right now it would be especially great for mobile journalists. Shoot something in the field and have the editor or producer back at the office start working immediately. Or if you're doing long form projects like a movie or documentary, this is an ideal option. Or if you do corporate video and have clients involved, this is another great tool to use for those kind of projects. To me, this is a natural fit using this type of technology, meaning your phone. While it also works great on high-end productions, you have to have a lot of additional expensive hardware to make it work. Here, it's all built right in. Of course, shooting on your phone is totally different than shooting on an Arri Alexa. But as phone video quality continues to improve, I could definitely see where this could be adopted by more and more professionals, depending on the type of project. You have to have an Adobe Creative Cloud subscription or a paid FrameIO account for all this to work. And since a lot of people already subscribe to Creative Cloud, this is gonna be a great value add for using that. But if you don't use Adobe, FrameIO is affordable. I've been a subscriber for several years, but since I also subscribe to Creative Cloud, I'll now be able to combine those, which will ultimately save me some money. So I think this is incredibly cool tech, and maybe one of those things you didn't know you needed until you try it. But what do you think? Let me know in the comments if you're interested in C2C and all the new updates going on here with FiLMiC Pro. Thanks for watching. This is Blake Calhoun. Please like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video talking about ProRes Log.